call me anything, but I know who I am. I am many things, but I'm not your average woman. You can call me anything, but God knows who I am. Educational, but not the wisest of them, though. Very spiritual, but I sustain all on my own. I'm misrepresented by the devil in the song. Holy people hear this beat and they wanna go home. I've had experiences in this area before. The way you look, you close, it starts to gossip at the door. I'm trying to tell you now, you think you know me, but you don't. Put your judgments to the side, cause only God judges his own. I am many things, but I'm not your average woman. You can call me anything, I know who I am. I am many things, but I'm not your average woman. You can call me anything, but God knows who I am. Many different faces contribute to different races. We all the same, but our troubles never change. Living in this world, I'm a soldier through the pain. The things you call me now is just the devil in my way. People try to hurt my flow, but I'm still here. Degrade my character, but I don't even care. I'm moving past the slice of others every day, living. My body may be weak, but my spirit is willing.
And here's the host of the Bridget Norville Show, Bridget Norville.
Perfect, everything's on that good scene. I mean, I'm stuck in a world where I can't just be me. So what if my nail polish always chips? So what if I prefer to wear my kicks? You know, models aren't really models when they're not modeling. Why don't you tell me something? Cause what I'm really wondering is how long do you expect to be following?
rising horse. Me, Hannibal, see ya. Hannibal, sir, G-O-D. 10 crazy folks who know me. It's your boy, Chimp. Out of his mind, I thought yesterday. Now I'm not playing with time. Tons spirit steady. Told some wine, scripted a prayer. And if you seen it, blind, I walk firm in the light. Turn it away. Fuck a die, bro. Today my soul's over ice. Believe I'm a blow if I hold on to Christ. Whip the praise and I unload on the mic. Know your boy never ever turn for the fight. He's coming back and get us like a thief in the night. Get tried.
Hi, welcome to the Bridget Norville Show. How are you today, Central Florida? I am in the house. Did you hear about J-E-S-U-S? No, I'm not going to try to sing it. Welcome to the show. Before I start, I want to go ahead and play some commercial, but we will be right back. Tell them the Bridget Norville Show is on the air.
Foundation of right choices and experiences. It's not important where you came from. It's not important what you did. What's important is where you're going. You choose where you want to go and what you want to be. Force is about helping you make the right choices. Force is about helping you see the possibilities. Force is about helping you apply the principles of God in you. Force gives you the tools to make it happen. Force, the foundation of right choices and experiences. The One True Army Force experience is coming to a ministry near you. For more information, go to www.forceconference.com. Brought to you by One True Army.
Get Get the 411 has the solution for your advertising and promotional needs. With affordable pricing, we can help you get the word out. Get the 411 has your marketing solution that meets your business demand, whether it's events, conference, social gathering, social networking, new businesses, or your latest CD. Get the 411 got you covered. With a loyal following over 100,000 regular readers worldwide, let internet marketing with Get the 411 become your method of choice for advertising needs. Contact us by email at info@getthe411.biz or log on to our website at www.getthe411.biz. Call us at 321-287-7419. That's 321-287-7419. And get the 411.
Welcome back to the show. Yes, this is the Bridget Norvell Show, and welcome. You know, today's show, I want to thank you for joining me again. And on this show, we'll be giving you some updates about what's going on around town and also speaking to my special guest about domestic violence. She's smiling over here. Yes, we're going to talk about domestic violence. And this is a very important topic because just last week there were two people died, one person injured from domestic violence. And as you know, I do have my story of different things, and domestic violence is one of them. I just got an invitation to a special television show for me to talk about my story. So I'm going to let you know about that next week and when to watch it so you can actually see Miss Bridget Norvell. But for now, we do have some announcements. Before I go into my topic, we do have some announcements. Today is the 5th annual Stop the Killing Rally. Their theme is Unity in the Community. This event will be held at the Maynard Evans High School on Pine Hills Road and Silver Star Road, between Pine Hills and Silver Star Road. It's going to be up until 4 p.m. You want to go out there and check them out. They're going to have free food. It is a free event. They're going to have special speakers and music and more. But they're going to talk about the Stop the Killing and how we can come united within the community. So I don't think you want to miss that. Again, it is up until 4 o'clock today, so you don't want to miss it. You have time to get out there. I was outside and it's nice and breezy. The sun is blowing. The wind is blowing. So everything is really good when it comes down to standing outside today. So if you want to go out, grab your chair, grab your, you know, you really don't even need your umbrella, but let's go out there and support. There's too many things going on within the Pine Hills area and all over. So I believe they're supposed to have the guest Trayvon Martin's parents are supposed to be out there also. That's the one that passed away from the gentleman shooting him because he had a hoodie on. So they're supposed to be out there. So go out there, tell them you heard it on the Bridget North Show. Give me a shout out, you know, but let's go out and support. Now, another upcoming event. I want to know, is your life on track? Do you need to get it back on track when it comes down to your health? Well, you want to check out the nutrition seminar. Miss Jackie Morris is going to be giving us a call at 12:30, telling us a little bit more about this upcoming event. But they're having a nutrition seminar Tuesday, October 9th, 2012 at 6:30 p.m. And like I said, she will give us more information on where it's going to be at and how you can participate in this upcoming event. But you don't want to miss these two events because it's very important. One is for our community and another one is for your nutrition and your health. We have to stay healthy. Without our health, we can't do anything else that God has called us to do. So I pray that you check it out. I want to also send a special shout out to our sponsors, UrbanOrlando.com. That's UrbanOrlando.com. And just the way it sounds, no slang, no nothing. It's UrbanOrlando.com. Check them out. And also get the 411.biz. Now, if you're having a little problem getting on Get the 411, it's because we have changed our look. We've changed our, we have a whole new facelift. You know, it's not only our regular faces can be lifted up in surgery and do cosmetic to it. We've done some cosmetic surgery to get the 411. So it's http://... get the411.biz. You know, when I first started out, I started out with a free website. But now, God, when God takes you to another level, you got to move with him. So we have moved on up. So if you want to find out more information about upcoming events, sponsors, conference, seminars and more, you want to get on Get the 411. And also, we specialize in email blasts. We have thousands and thousands of subscribers. So if you want an email blast sent out, we're doing a special right now that you would really, for, you know, we're trying to fit it for the economy, so it would benefit you as a business. We're doing $50 email blasts and packages, different packages. So just check us out at http://... get the 411. And I also wanted to thank my actual next sponsor, and that's forceconference.com. That's forceconference.com. Yes, the commercial you hear about Force, I am part of One True Army, and as you know, that my program is changing you from the inside out. So in the process of being changed and my awesome stories of all the things I've went through, I've also started a program called Changing You from the Inside Out. And Changing You from the Inside Out has now partnered with Force, One True Army, and we are doing different conferences. We're having different speakers come in. It's awesome because it's time for us to really learn how to walk in our change, walking and applying it to our life. So that's it for our sponsors and the announcement. Tweet me on Twitter, Bridget Norvell, that's BRIDGET, no extra E's, no extra T's, just one T. Take a bridge and put a T to it. That's Bridget Norvell on Twitter, or Miss Norvell. I believe I changed it to Bridget Norvell, but you can find me. It's not hard to find me. Or go ahead and send me a message on Facebook, a friend request on Facebook, and that's also Bridget Norvell, NORVELL, and also Instagram, and Foursquare, all over. I'm all over the place. So when it comes down to me and the social network world, I do it big. So go ahead, send me a friend request. I need all the friends I can get, you know. So if you're listening all over the country, because I just went ahead and put it on Facebook, if you're listening, send me a friend request. Tell me how you think about what you think about the show and what more you'll like to hear from the show to help you. Now, that's our announcement. Now, we're going to get into our topic, domestic violence. Domestic violence, as I explained, that domestic violence is really something that is hidden and we really don't know much about, because in every family, someone is experiencing domestic violence. And I'm big on parenting, and I started the week before talking about how it's important to raise your children correctly, because when you don't, This, you'll see sociopaths, you'll see enablers, codependent, and these are the things that will allow us to fall into this area of domestic violence. We either become the abuser or abusive, you know, abused. So we're going to talk about it today. Now, my guest, Natasha Daniels, I want to thank you for joining us.
Anytime.
You're going to have to talk. She's so shy. So you're going to have to talk up.
Pleasure is all mine. I'm glad to be here.
I can talk to her like that because I'm like kind of mentoring her too. So she's going to talk about today. She has a lot of stories, but I think the one that we want to really focus on today is when, what really touched me was when she talked about her situation in domestic violence and what she had to go through, you know. And we're going to learn today, what is domestic violence? After we hear her story, we're going to talk about what is domestic violence and abuse? How do you stop it? And we're going to talk about that. Now, our guest is going to tell us her story. She do have a book called Diary
of a 27-year-old that danced in the rain.
Yes. And explain to us a little bit, what did that mean? You know, you'll be surprised. I'm not going to give it away. I'm going to let you tell them.
It came over me, Diary of a 27-year-old that danced in the rain, because I have a life full of hidden secrets. And so God has allowed me to go through some things and to come over those many obstacles that I went through, you know, to help somebody else mm-hmm. with their obstacles. But before I laid everything on the map, I wanted to go ahead and blast my diary, the secrets that I've never told anyone, the many secrets that my mother and my grandparents and everyone should have known, but they didn't. I kept it to myself all the way until the release date of mm-hmm. July the 7th of 2012.
Okay.
And basically, you know, it's a lot of things that I've went through, a lot of things that I've put myself through that was nobody else's fault but mine. Mm-hmm. You know, I got into a lot of trouble. I was a troubled child on the low. You know, mm-hmm. my parents had no knowledge of knowing, you know, so I just wanted to put that out there because that's what today's society and today's world is facing right now. You know, I just want to let the people know that they're not alone. And it's also a message towards the parents inside this book, because basically, you know, we get so caught up as parents, we get so caught up in our own issues mm-hmm. and fighting in front of our kids, like what we're talking about now, domestic violence, and carrying on in front of our children to the point they go through things and they experience things, but because we as children see our parents going through, mm-hmm. we don't want to put that extra burden on them, so we remain quiet.
Yes, and I'm glad you said that, because a lot of times too, as parents, we get into relationships and we see this cycle of our children getting into the same problem, the same cycle. And you're like, how did they get there? Is because of what they saw. And when it comes down to domestic violence, I'm going to give you a list of what is domestic violence, because a lot of times we don't know that we are in a dysfunctional relationship. And I know you're saying, well, we should know we are. Mm-hmm. Once you become, it's called a learned behavior.
Yes.
Once we become in a grow up in a dysfunctional behavior, yes. once we're in that other behavior, that lifestyle, we don't know that that's not normal. And we see, you know, I remember when I was growing up, and oh Lord, I hope no one's okay. Yes, I am that mature. Leave it to Beaver. We used to watch Leave It to Beaver, and you know, all those other little family oriented shows.
Yeah. Brady Bunch.
The Brady Bunch, and all those little sweet little shows. You know, you see the family that's functioning correctly.
Yes.
But now you don't, you know, like that's just TV.
Yes.
And you have to go into the real world.
Yes.
Of seeing how the family is being raised, and the family is as a whole being out of order.
Exactly.
Now, I am going to open up the phone lines for you if you have any questions for Natasha as we're talking about domestic violence and her story. But the number is 407-834-0909. That's 407-834-0909. But I want to give you a list, and you tell me if this is what you were seeing in your family and what took you off track. The signs are if your partner is physically hurting you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so did you see, you saw that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Insult or talk down to you.
Yes.
Threaten you with harm.
Yes.
Scream or curse at you.
Yes.
If your answer is yes, you might want to rethink your relationship.
Yes, you really do.
Because like you said, when you were silent, tell me a little about what happened to you that made you see it and become silent. And at what age?
I actually saw my mother and my grandmother go through it.
Okay.
And not only them, just about every female in my family go through it. And mm-hmm. my diagnosis to this equation was it's a generational curse.
Mm-hmm.
And it just keeps regurgitating and regurgitating and regurgitating and regurgitating. And I believe that's what goes on in every family. Mm-hmm. And every female, every male picks up this same cycle, and they keep regurgitating the cycle. They do what they see.
And eventually, like we said, it has to stop. And my story is that it stopped with me.
Yes.
With my story, and I want you to begin to tell me, because what happened with your story? Because mm-hmm. like I said, I was abused.
Yes.
By my grandparents, mm-hmm. by my mom, and then turned around, went into abusive relationships. Mm-hmm. And November 27th is another anniversary coming up, and we call it domestic survivor.
Yes.
I was supposed to die November 27th, 1994.
Wow.
And the man that I was with, he actually, I mean, put from the gun to my head to actually wanted to kill both of us in a car.
Wow.
So he died that night.
Yes.
So that's why I remember the date so well.
Yes.
Because instead of me dying, he died. No, I did not kill him out there. But I didn't kill him. But that night, unfortunately, he got shot.
Okay.
By someone else. And it's a long story. I have to put my book together one day. I am putting it together, but it's not for really the people. It's for my healing. It's a healing that I've went through from the change from the inside out. Mm-hmm. And it's for my children's children.
Exactly.
Now, what I notice, and we talked about this,
mm-hmm.
you now end up in a abusive relationship.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Well, my first was my first boyfriend. You know,
so you had several?
Yeah, I had several.
Okay.
You know, I had the best of both worlds.
Mm-hmm.
And I experienced that with a female and a male. But see, one thing about it with the female, what they fail to realize, we bleed out the same area. You're not finna just put your hands on me and expect not to get hit back. But it seemed like, you know, with this one particular female, I just couldn't stand to hit her back.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't stand to force myself into a physical confrontation with her, because before we were into that relationship, mm-hmm. we were like best friends. And
okay.
I just did. She was like a sister. It was weird.
Well, let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
Who was the first one that drove you experienced violence from, you know, the abuse from? Was it the man or the woman?
It was the Well, at the same time, I was, you know, I told you.
You were dating both of
yeah.
them.
Yeah.
This is getting good. Okay, you got to get Natasha book. matter of fact, we're going to give this book away. 407-834-0909 407-834-0909, because this, you know, this is like a plot. It's a twist. You know, you don't have to call in, you don't have to go to Dynasty and look for what is called call. Are you on the line? Okay, if I cannot hear you, it's because okay. Can you call back? Give us like 2 more minutes. I'm going to go ahead and exit call for you to call back. But I'm sorry, I cannot hear you. Okay. But like I said, when you look at, when you read Natasha's book, I hope I'm saying it right. Humdinger. I know we both have stories, mm-hmm. but go ahead. So it was the woman
and the man. I was both, you know,
dating both of them
at the same time. But see, what happened was I thought I was smart. I ain't really have it all together. But the man, he was finding out, you know, through people that he was indulging with in the streets, that, you know, I was dating females, and they would always be at my mom's house. And one particular night, he ended up coming over there, and she spent the night over there.
Okay.
And he sat in the couch, and he smelled the scent on me that, you know, that I was doing something I didn't have no business doing. So she ended up going home periodically, because I was, you know, I felt like that was my bread and butter, so I'm gonna sit there and chill with him, you know, me and you just having fun. But she ended up going home, and later on that night I experienced it. I got my behind tore out.
So from the guy. So did you feel that, and I know it started from your upbringing and you growing up and seeing things mm-hmm. going on within the family.
Yes.
Now, is this something that you felt within yourself that you needed this type of, how can I say, for me, it was love.
Yeah.
For me, this is saying a person loved me. Mm-hmm. This
That's
is
what
my,
I was thinking too.
Okay.
I was like, well, you know, I'm in the wrong, you know, so if he wants me to act accordingly to his will, mm-hmm. well, maybe I guess he got to beat it out of me. You know, he's just beating me out of love. That's how I felt.
Okay.
But then I'm like, man, hold on. I'm too pretty to be going through this. You're not
okay,
gonna be beating on me like that.
So you thought about, you're too pretty to go through this, but now you go to a woman for her to do the same thing to you. What were you thinking?
I don't know. I was so young and back then dumb.
How old were you?
I was about 17, going on 18.
Okay.
And at that time, I had my own place, and he was paying all the bills. I guess that's why he... And I used to go to my mom's house to do all my dirt.
Okay.
And so, you know, we ended up breaking up, me and the guy, and... me and the girl started getting a little heavy, and come to find out, you know, she ends up getting caught dating someone else.
Mm-hmm.
And just because she gets caught up, you know, she wants to beat me getting mad. So she shows up to my friend's house, and we eventually start fighting.
Okay.
And that fight led to a whole 2 weeks worth of field day fighting.
Wow.
Machetes getting thrown, swords getting thrown. It was crazy.
Okay. Well, listen, we have a caller on the line. The lines are going off. Caller, are you on the line?
Yes, I am.
How are you?
I am blessed. How are you?
Great. Thank you for calling in. Are you calling in to win a book from the
Yes, Tasha? I am.
Yes. We're going to take down your information. Natasha, you were also on the show that I'm going to be on, The Journey.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you could tell us when that's going to air. What's your name, caller?
Jackie Jones.
Jones, okay. And if you can hold on, we're going to get your telephone number. We're going to put you on hold and get your telephone number. Hold on just a moment. We're going to get your telephone number. Okay. And I think you got it. Okay, he got your number. Okay, we're going to go ahead and play a song, and we're going to get your number while we're off air. We'll be right back with the Bridget Norvell Show.
Okay, thank you.
Can't forgive or forget. We hold on, and it's dangerous. It's dangerous. So dead. Junk would do is push you farther away. And every time I see you acting like it's all okay, you were the last one I ever thought would fall away. I never thought you'd change, never thought you'd stray. Run right back to the very things I know you hate. With all you've gone through, now tell me why you go this way. Caught up in the jungle, going where you came. Caught up on the run, you're every day the same. You hold your head up high, living it without no shame. And every day it gets a little harder just to pray. If I could sit you down, here's what I say. Can't forgive or forget. We hold on and it's dangerous. It's dangerous. We resent, we regret. We look back, but it's dangerous. Living like we do is so dangerous.
Your wings are broken. Welcome back to the Bridget Norvell Show. Well, I want to say congratulations to Jackie Jones. She just won a book. She was telling us a little about what she had went through off air. And domestic violence is really serious. But before we get back into our conversation, we have Jackie Morris on the line. Jackie, thank you so much for calling in. And tell us a little about your upcoming event.
Okay, thank you very much, Bridget. My name is Jackie Morris, a registered dietitian and president of Annex Nutrition Services Incorporated. I would like to thank Ms. Bridget for allowing me the opportunity to share with what we're going to be doing with our company. We will be having a free seminar on next Tuesday, October 9th, at the Medela Resource Center, located at 149 Parker Road, Lakeland, Florida. We will begin at 6:30 p.m. sharp. As you know, obesity is on the rise in Florida, and we need to do something about it. Our topic is get back on track, optimizing your health through proper nutrition. Many of us have made New Year resolutions, which we have not kept. You have an opportunity to learn from the expert how to manage your weight, learn about portion size, caloric content of foods, why fat diets don't work, and how to effectively manage your cholesterol, diabetes, and high blood pressure. Again, it's a free seminar scheduled for Tuesday, October 9th at the Medela Resource Center, Parker Road, Lakeland, Florida. You can reach us at 863-588-2652 or go to our website at annexnutritionservices.com to reserve your seating. We look forward to having you share the evening with us as we learn how to manage our weight and to have a better health as we end up close out 2012.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Bridget.
You're welcome. And y'all don't want to miss that. Like she said, you want to close out your 2012 correctly. Obesity is on the rise. I know what she's talking about because it's really running rapid, and we need to be healthy, like I said, from the inside out. So check out that upcoming event. That's 863-588-2652. That's 863-588-2652. Give Jackie Morris a call and check out that upcoming events, and let's start getting healthy. Well, now back to our conversation with Miss Natasha. with Natasha, she was talking about, now she was talking about the woman. Now, how did you get involved with the woman? Now you're saying, I'm too pretty for the man to hit me like that. But now you step into another abusive relationship. And this is why I say that the abuse, if you suppress it long enough, you now become the abuser. Because you have a story. I want them to tell you how you end. Okay, go ahead. Just tell us a little about that. And I want us to segue into your abuse. You now becoming the abuser.
Yeah. That's what I was just about to say. I ended up, you know, coming to abuser. You know, I was getting hit on. Then I ended up taking poles and beating up on stuff, and then just getting myself into this really, really big altercation. And then after that, you know, I sat back and did some self-evaluation, like, okay, I'm tired of going through this. You know, any female should have enough value and morals about themselves to want to become greater than just keep getting in trouble or keep fighting, because that's not what life is all about. So I sequestered myself and isolated myself, and for a while started going to church and gave my life to God. Then shortly after, I backslid, started doing some things I didn't have any business doing, met my baby father, ended up getting pregnant, and started getting abused again. I'm like, okay. Wow. You know, he beat me while I was 9 months pregnant with my son. He really, 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 really beat me.
But in the process of him beating you, now there's something that you said that you did. And it's in the book. So you have to get the book. 407-834-0909. Now we're going to go give one more book away, if that's okay. But tell us, what did you do?
I just can't stand to be, if things aren't going your way, and if you can't stand correction, don't call me out of my name, because that's not my name.
So this is what he did.
Yeah, I would not be tolerated, because I have 12 brothers and sisters and my dad and uncles. Never was disrespected by them or called out of my name. I wasn't raised like that.
But the thing is, like you said, you did see on the parent side of what your mom went through. So though that you feel that you weren't supposed to be called out your name, you've seen something that you learned that was going on. And I want you to get to, because I know you told me about the arrests.
Yes,
go ahead.
You know, my baby father, I loved him dearly, and I still do to this day. But he has this thing, and, you know, I can't fault him for it, because he I see the way his dad treats his mom and, you know, that type of thing. That's why I say it's like a generational curse. But you're not finna call me out of my name. I am not your B.
That what led up to whatever you did?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
You know, I can't stand to, like, hear someone in my face or see someone in my face just keep nagging, just calling me, you know, out of my name. And so, you know, one thing led to another. But while I was pregnant, I did not fight him back. I was too busy trying to protect my baby, because I didn't want to lose my baby.
Now, did you have a boy or girl?
I had a boy at the
boy.
Time.
Okay, so your son's father. I'd love to correct that, because we have a way of saying baby mamas and baby daddies. No. It's mother and fathers. And that's what happened, is that we have the baby mama, the baby daddies. Everyone's staying in this cycle of not growing up. So it's your, when you become a mom, you're a mom, a mother, and then there's a father. Now, a father has responsibilities. But if we take them out of that equation of being the baby daddy, you know, and change our thinking. So I just want to throw that in there. But let's get to the story of what happened when he did speak to you in a manner that you were not pleased by.
You know, after you know, we got into a fight, I eventually called the police, my mom, everybody came around to the house, and he ended up going to jail. And, you know, me, old gullible me, I dropped the charges, and he got out. And, you know, we were good for a few months. And
so you took him back?
Yeah, I took him back.
Okay. Now, if you listen to the Bridget Norvell show, I talk about parenting. Mm-hmm. And because of a certain age from 0 to 4, you have your self. You're learning your ego. If mm-hmm. you don't, you have your sociopath. Mm-hmm. So your sociopath now finds from 5 to 7 people pleasing. And if you don't learn how to gratify yourself by accepting what it is that how you are, like you said, building your self-esteem, mm-hmm. now you're looking at the sociopath looking for the codependent, the enabler. So this is a prime example of an enabler. Yeah. Though that he might have been taking care of everything, you were still giving him that person that love, enabling that love. Yeah. And like I said, I do mentor Natasha, so I could talk to Natasha this way. Because I'm proud of Natasha. Natasha is 27 years old. Well, she turned 28. Yeah. She had to add that extra number. And she was prophesied about this book, and she wrote it. And a lot of us still have books in us. Well, my book is on paper, but
it's very therapeutic. Everyone has a story to tell, and I just wish everyone tell it.
Yes.
So we can pick each other up instead of downing one another.
Yes.
You know, because hurt people, that's where a lot of domestic violence mm-hmm. and a lot of, you know, mental violence, because a lot of it is, a lot of people can just use their
suppressing
mouth
their hurt.
And hurt someone.
And I'm glad you said that, because when we see a person using violence or abuse with mm-hmm. their mouth or with their hand, mm-hmm. it's a power and control wheel.
Yes.
To break down the power and control, the sense of control is fear. Mm-hmm. And they want to put fear in you, what they fear the most. We always said hurt people, mm-hmm. but hurt people is hurt within themselves. Mm-hmm. They just need something or someone to get that anger out. So like I always say that from hurt, you work with fear. Mm-hmm. Fear is becomes hurt. Mm-hmm. Hurt now becomes pain. Pain becomes anger. And anger becomes rage.
Yes.
So you're seeing people run around with rage. The first characteristics is the fear that mm-hmm. they haven't dealt with. Now, they will use threats.
Yes.
They use intimidation. Mm-hmm. They use isolation.
Yes.
Minimizing, denying, and blaming.
Exactly.
And superior, like a male will use, like, I am superior. You're supposed to worship me. Mm-hmm. And using economic abuse. And we could call that's part of your control wheel.
Exactly.
And I've learned about this wheel from the Harbor House with being a partner just last week. Yes, it was last week we went, and they were talking about the wheel, but I've known this wheel because I was on both coins, and I know you exactly. could relate to
yes.
that.
Yes.
Now, you said something about, I think one night you told me about the gun.
Oh, yeah, and you caught the gun charges.
Yes, the gun charge.
Yeah, that was when I had just had my daughter.
Mm-hmm.
And